بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، اما بعد، قال الله تبارك وتعالى في الكلام المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الذين امنوا نجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعد الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا في مقام آخر قال الله تبارك وتعالى وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنا عند الظن عبدي بي أيضا قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الطائب حبيب الله صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن ولا ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين صلوا على النبي نبی کی ذات روح شپڑے محبت سے اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم صلی علیہ رب اشرح لي صدری ويسر لي امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی يفقهوا قولی رب زدنی علما سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العلیم الحکیم رب یسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخیر مائی موسٹ آنریبل برادرز اینڈ سسٹر ان اسلام اینڈ ناظرین السلام علیکم رحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ فسٹ آف آل وی شوڈ برنگ اور ہارٹس اینڈ اور مائنڈ ان دا اسٹیٹ آف شکر یا اللہ وی ہیو نو ورڈ ہاؤ مچ ادد یو نو وی تھینک یو ویری مچ یا اللہ تھینک یو ویری مچ اللہ اکبر یا اللہ تھینک یو ویری شکر الحمد للہ رب العالمین یو بلیس اس ود ایمان اینڈ اسلام ود آؤٹ آور اینی پرپز فل ایفرٹ آئی کوٹڈ بفور یو آیت مبارکہ سمپل میننگ یا ایھا الذین آمنوا اجتنبوا کثیرا من الظن او بلیورز ڈونٹ میک سو مینی ایزمپشنز Don't assume a lot of things because some assumptions are invalid, are not good, are sin. Some assumptions are sin. We should not do guesswork about other people. We should not. Vala tajassasu. Don't spy on the people. Don't find fault among the people. Don't do it. Another ayat mubarakah I quoted. وَفِي أَنفُسَكُمْ أَفْلَا تُبْصِرُونَ Why don't you look in your own self? You're looking toward other people. Why you look your own faults? But we are. Then I quoted to Hadith Pak. أَنَا إِنْدَ ذَنِّ عَبْدِي بِي I deal with the person, my banda, how he think about me, how he has done assumption about me. Adar hadith se paak, At-taibu habibullah, the person who does tawbah from the sins, come back on the right track, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him, he becomes the mehboob of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let's look the outward dunya. You see sky, sun, moon, beautiful trees, beautiful flowers. We see the qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See our outer part of the body. Nose is right place. If you think nose this side, how I look? Eyes are right place, covered by the bones. There's no eye over here. He is the right place. Outer part of the body, you think how beautiful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us. This is outer part, out of Qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It increases our iman. And look into the inner part of the body. There is a lot of machinery inside. Mama did not make it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was making construction inside the body also. Kidney, liver, heart. Who started heart to beat first time? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He will stop. How many miles, millions of miles there are veins in the body? Subhanallah. So this is the Qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, when we do hasana, neki, then what happened? Shaitan pop in us, the arrogance. Every neki create arrogance also. Ujib also. I did it. Me. I did it. And as a result of that, we look down other people. Oh, I made Juma. He did not make Juma. He is collecting money, dollar. I made Juma. All these negative ideas come from Shaitan, make you superior to others. When he make us think superior to others, then we start finding fault from other people. Then दूसरों के ऐप ढूंढते हैं. न थी अपनी बुराइयों की खबर न थी अपनी बुराइयों की खबर रहे ढूंढते औरों के ऐबो हुनर बड़ी अपनी बुराइयों पे जब नजर तो जहां में कोई बुरा ना रहा. When we look our own self, how many fault I had, how many spiritual disease I have, then we will not see anybody other is bad. Because when we stop looking our own faults, our own mistakes, our own shortcoming, when we stop this, then I go to others. So when we start looking our own self, then I will not go to others. Therefore, the wise Muslim is that where Quran Hadith Pass says, we should look to our own fault. Then we will not start backbiting and mocking the people or passing sarcastic remarks. It's a very, very important thing. So, he's a lucky person. He's a fortunate Muslim, fortunate woman to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave tawfiq to watch himself, to find his own fault, to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed the mirror. If you look at the mirror, you find spot, bad spot on your face yourself. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, He shows our own fault so that we repair ourselves. We remove our fault, we remove our sins. Then as a result of that, will be very easy with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go to Jannah. So we should make dua. Ya Allah, help me to, I should see my own sins, my own fault, my own shortcoming. Who am I? Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه used to say, Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه used to say, who will bring me the gift of my fault? जो मेरे पास मेरे ऐबों का तोहफा लेकर आएगा, I will make dua for his maghfirah. Allahu Akbar. जो मेरे पास मेरे ऐबों का तोहफा लेके आएगा, who will bring to me the gift of my fault, Omar, you have this problem, you have this problem, you have this fault, you have this, you are making this mistake. I will make dua for his maghfira. Who's Omar? You know that. Where we stand? Do we? If anybody come to me, Sheikh Khokhar, you have this problem. I don't like it. But I will say, no, 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 no. I don't have problem. You might have problem. Am I right? We don't accept it. If you go to the doctor, physical doctor, and he say, he check everything. He said, you have high blood sugar. You have this problem in the heart. Do we say no? Tell me, no. We say, yes, thank you very much. Dr. Saab, second opinion also. Thank you, take another test. But that is about physical health. I accept right away. But about spiritual health? Somebody tell me, you, Maulana, sometime you backbite. I don't, no, 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 I never backbite. You might be backbiting. This is a misunderstanding. I don't accept it. I'm not a wise person. It's a problem for me. You should know that the spiritual health is more important than physical health. If we have bad physical health, worst come worst, and the result will be what? Cover, body got sick, doctor gave medicine, never work, body die, you put in the grave, and body consumed, finished, perished, halas, that's it. On the other hand, if I have inner problem, if I have arrogance, kibar, Hadith Pak says, the person who has arrogance, kibar in the heart, he cannot enter paradise and cannot smell the fragrance of the paradise. Why? Because the ruh does not die, body finish. Ruh does not finish. Ruh will live forever and ever and ever. The ruh will take the good habits, good characteristics and bad also. The ruh will take the all spiritual diseases with it. And then that ruh will be taken to the hospital of Jahannam for a while to clean up the junk. So we have to keep our ruh spirit free from every kind of sin so that it will be easy for us to enter Jannah. Soon we take last breath with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Mujaddid al-Fasani, rahmatullah, used to say, listen, there are elders, how Umar Farooq used to say, who will bring me the gift of my fault, I will make dua for him. Maghfirat. Hazrat Mujaddid al-Fasani, rahmatullah, used to say, for 20 years, he said, I am not exaggerating, I am speaking truth. For 20 years, I don't know my this angel, right side angel, has written any my good deed. Great Mujaddid. Where we stand now? Because our naked, our good deed also has some sins hidden there. Even our good deed has some kind of sin. Example, making salat very good. Allahu Akbar, I make salat. But where in my heart? In the business, right? So, this is not good salat. I made salat, but it has sin inside. Sometimes I do hajj for showpiece. After 2 years, guests come. And I don't tell them I did Hajj, I'm Haji Sahab. I tell my son, okay, bring me that gift, what I brought for the son, from the Hajj. Our nekriya bhi, bhai gunahon se bhari hui. That's why it is recommended when we make Salatu Tawbah. So all sin we commit in the Salat will be forgiven and Salat will be accepted as a good Salat. हमारे गुनाह भी गुनाह तो गुनाह हैं, हमारी नेकियां भी गुनाहों से भरी होती बार दफ़ा. तो हाउ वी फील प्राइड, ओनली मर्सी ऑफ अल्लाह सुब्हान अल्लाह, बट वी विल डू आवर बेस्ट टू डू गुड डीड. हज़रत थानवी रहमतुल्लाह अलैह यू टू से, आई थिंक एवरी अदर पर्सन मुस्लिम स्पेशली एहतसाबन इज बेटर देन मी. नेकियों के लिहाज से हर दूसरा मुसलमान मुझसे बेहतर है. हज़रत मोहम्मद अशरफ अली थानवी रहमतुल्लाह अलैह मुजद्दद मिल्लत, ही रोड 114 बुक्स, ही हर थाउजेंड थाउजेंड हिज स्टूडेंट्स स्पिरिचुअल स्टूडेंट्स ग्रेट. ये तफसीर बयान कुरान, ही टेलिंग दिस, आई थिंक एवरी अदर वोमन इज बेटर देन मी सब आपके एहतसाबन. एंड फर्दर ही सेड अलार्मिंग थिंग, बट ही सेड आई थिंक एवरी अदर काफिर इज आल्सो बेटर देन मी एहतमालन, मे बी टुमारो देयर काफिर बिकम मुस्लिम एंड आई डोंट गारंटी अबाउट माई इस्लाम एंड ईमान. यस आर नो? कैन वी गारंटी? नो. लिहाजा सो वी शुड थिंक एवरी अदर बेटर देन मी. वी नो दैट वी मैन हस्बैंड्स 99% हस्बैंड थिंक बेटर देन द वाइफ इवन शी राबिया बसरिया. वी मे एस दुआ हजरत जी मेघ दुआ मौलाना मेघ दुआ, वी नेवर एस द वाइफ हनी मेघ दुआ फॉर मी बिकॉज वी आर एरोगेंट. तो वी हैव टू कीप आवर क्लीन फॉर दैट. बाकी व्हाट वी आर वी नो दैट ये तेरा कर्म है आका के बात अब तक बनी हुई है. अदरवाइज व्हाट वी आर वी नो दैट. नाउ व्हाट शुड वी डू? नाउ हाउ वी टेक दिस प्रॉब्लम? वी शुड डू आवर फिजिकल चेकअप एवरी ईयर आर एवरी सिक्स मंथ फॉर मेडिकल चेकअप बिकॉज बॉडी इज गिफ्ट ऑफ अल्लाह सुब्हान व तआला. एट द सेम टाइम वी शुड डू आवर स्पिरिचुअल चेकअप ऑल्सो कि वट प्रॉब्लम आई हैव, वट बैड हैबिट्स आई हैव. डू आई बैक बाइट? डू हैव आई एम एरोगेंट? आई हैव टू मच एंगर? आई हैव ग्रज? डू आई हैव? सो वी कैन सीक हेल्प फ्रॉम द वाइफ. माई वाइफ नोज मी बेटर देन एनीबडी एल्स. मे बी आउटसाइड मे बिग शेख खोखर, बट शी नोज वट आई एम. थर्ड थिंग, वी शुड फाइंड ए फ्रेंड, गुड सिंसियर फ्रेंड. वी शुड मेक ए काउंटर विद हिम. माई ब्रदर यू आर माई फ्रेंड, आई हेल्प यू, यू हेल्प मी. If I make any mistake, if you find any default in me, please let me know. Good idea. If I find something in you, I'll let you know. Good friendship, good contract, it will help us a lot. Then some our relatives are jealous of us. They give comment. The jealous people who are jealous of my family, jealous of me, their comments are very, very good. But their comments are, I should take notice. My enemies, what they comment about me, bad comment, I should think over it. I must have same problem. Then we should have self-evaluation is very important. Before sleeping, self-evaluation. What good I do, what bad I do. On good, we do shukr. On bad, we should do tawbah. At-tayyibu habibullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who does tawbah, loves him. we can become mehbub of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing tawbah. We should be also aware of the tricks of shaitan, how he put bad idea in our mind. We should take our nafs. Nafs is a big enemy. Shaitan is a big enemy. But let me tell you frankly, nafs and shaitan, the very simple, their tricks are cheating we can handle. But for real training of the nafs, we need a spiritualist, we need a sheikh who's expert of this area. We have a family doctor, we have physical doctor. Why we don't have a religious spiritual doctor? We need a spiritual doctor. When I see any bad habit in me, I have to go to sheikh, I have this problem. He will evaluate me. I stay in his company of the sheikh. You should have connection with any scholar and alim I trust to take care of our spiritual diseases. Until we don't find, we should read the books of mashayikh. I quote before sometime, told you before also, Arba'in. By Ghazali Rahmatullah, Imam Ghazali Rahmatullah, Ahya'i Ulum, beautiful book. Imam Ghazali Rahmatullah, Mizaqul Arifin. This is a translation of Kimya Sa'adat, beautiful book. So, was of some ulama-i haq. So we can read those. Bahishti Zebar, it covers some. The remedies of spiritual diseases by Ibn Taymiyyah Rahimullah. After we find any sheikh, we should read these books and take care of our diseases so that we can enjoy Jannah right after closing the eyes. We should do zikr Allah. Zikr of La ilaha illallah, take care lot of spiritual diseases. Morning, evening, sit down. Every Thursday, there's a majlis-e zikr. Every Thursday, there's a majlis-e zikr in this masjid. You can come to the majlis-e zikr in this masjid. MashaAllah, Hazrat does the zikr, jahar, it will take away a lot of your diseases, spiritual diseases. But we don't value. Free thing, we don't value it. We should eat less food. Less eating, less sleeping, less talking is a good medicine to save ourselves from a spiritual diseases. Less eating, less talking, and less sleeping. In the Khanqa, the spiritual place Thana Bhavan in India, has a Thalmi Rahmatullah. Anybody come there? Silent. Nobody can talk. The way he used to train. Even Hazrat Majzub Rahmatullah, he had a katba in the neck. Silent. Hamosh. Silent. Because silence, if we speak, keep silence, less speaking, less speech, it will save us from the sins of the tongue. This passage says, so many people will be thrown in the hellfire headlong because of the misuse of the tongue. Control your tongue. We should stay in the company of the pious people. In the company of the pious people, sometimes looking at the pious people, the heart are changed. Yak zamana, sohbate ba awliya. Yak zamana, sohbate ba awliya. Better as sad sala atat beria. Little company of the past people is better than 1,000-year ibadah. We should enjoy the company of Ulama-e Haq and Sulaha-e Haq. We need somebody for training. For spiritual health, we need a doctor. We need somebody company a guideline. In elementary school, middle school, high school, college, every student has to have a counselor called guidance teacher. Yes or no? For worldly education, we need counselor. What about religious education? The student cannot register in the courses until he go to his counselor for the counseling. For dunya education, what about our spiritual education? What about our physical, spiritual health? For our jannah, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for happy life, for mutmainna life, life of peace, we need counseling. The person, sometimes you advise some person, he don't accept it. This is a sign of arrogance. If you advise somebody, he doesn't accept it. This is a sign of the arrogance. This is the biggest disease which, what happened to Shaitan? Devil has same problem. He had two problems. Jealousy, hasad, and kibar, arrogance. His ibadat did not work for him. We have to be watchful. Imam Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the under the supervision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was training all the anbiya, especially Rasulullah, he was giving him a training. Little mistake prophet made right away. Allah said, you're correct. Aba sahaba tawalla. Ibn Maktoum, when he came, prophet was busy with the other big shot. Talking to you about the dawa, the prophet did not pay attention to Ibn Maktoum. Right away, guidance came from Allah. Abba sabata Allah. Why you frown at him? Pay attention to that person. Allah was training. Rasul Akram was under the training of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sahaba Karam was being trained by whom? Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes or no? That's why they call Sahabi. Sohbat. Company of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Heart was being changed. Imam Abu Hanifa, great faqih, mashallah. He is the Imam who saw some Sahaba Akram. Subhanallah. For his spiritual health, he used to go Imam Jafar Sadiq, rahmatullah alayh. Can you believe it? Imam Abu Hanifa, big faqih, for his spiritual health, he used to go Imam Jafar Sadiq. Imam Shafi, rahmatullah, for his spiritual health, inner well-being, he used to go Sheikh Hasan Shaibani rahmatullah alayh. Imam Abd bin Hanbal, he used to go to Hazrat Bashar Hafiz rahmatullah alayh, great Sheikh Allah wala. Come on. Rashid Ahmad Gangohi rahmatullah alayh. Hazrat Mujaddid Millat Thanvi rahmatullah alayh. These big scholars, back of the time, Shidam Gangohi rahmatullah alayh, great, for his spiritual health, they used to go Haji Imdadullah Shah Sahib Hajar Bakki rahmatullah alayh, under their training. Somebody objected, Rashid Ahmad, you are so great scholar, Why you need to go, Haji Saab? He is not as scholar as you are. He answered, Haji Saab, the place is a shop of the Mathai. We know the name of the sweets. This is a barfi, this is jalebi. We know the name only. Haji Saab tasted. He has taste of all these. He has spiritual taste. When he one time, Maharaj Sri Ramakrishna Gohil Ramtullah went to him first time in the majlis. There was food going on. There were biryani, kebab, everything, but dal also. The Haji Saab, to give him training, does he have kibar or not? Because ilm create kibar. Our ulama become arrogant. Every good deed create kibar. So Haji Saab called him, Rashid, come here. No Ahmad, Rashid, come here. And he called him and gave a roti and roti over dal. Take it, eat it. I'm nice to you, otherwise I was putting you in the place of the shoes. Now he's watching also, what he think, what his mind, forehead. Maharshi Ram told Hazrat, I am not able to sit in the shoes also. It means, nafs mara hua hai. Yes. Nafs marega hi, to bhai kaam banega, varna musibat hai. Nahango azdaha, shereo nahango azdaha, shere babar, mara to kya mara, bade muzi ko mara, nafs ammara ko gar mara. Translation. You may kill the big crocodile. You may kill the big serpent snake or big lion. This is not a big deal. Big deal is this, if you kill your own nafs ammara, nafs with a bad desire, and everybody is born with nafs ammara. In nafs ammara to bisu. Yusuf al-Islam said clearly, nafs ammara, we have to change it to nafs al-labama. Uncontrolled desires. One wife, second wife looking for, third looking for, one business, second, third, fourth. Okay, today Friday, lot of JFK passenger, let me make our salat to gather five after Isha salat. Let me pick up, pick up, pick up. The whole nafs, desires. We have to control our nafs. If we lack control, train our nafs, and it can be done easily with the company of a mashayikh who are spiritualists, who know how to take care of nafs. And I quote you some books also can help you. What is nafs? I am better than other. This is homework I am giving you now, please. Check yourself always at Isha time. Do I think I'm better than somebody else? Make sure. Every other person better than me. The first step. We should continue keeping check up our spiritual health, which is more important. Spiritual sickness will take to Jahannam. We cannot afford it. We should keep eye open on us, our physical diseases as well as our spiritual diseases. Before sleeping, evaluate yourself. Self-evaluation. Muhasaba. Hasabu. Kabalanta hasabu. Before we get accountability, before Allah wants to check us, after death, we should check ourselves. So keep checking ourselves and keep correcting ourselves. And also, last thing, not least, we should make dua also. Ya Allah, help me. Help me to clean up all my spiritual diseases. Ya Allah, kyo, all my spiritual diseases, I don't know, I'm very weak. Please, Allah, help me. Wa akhiru da'wana, an alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, jazakallah khair.